Hello and welcome to the lecture series on automobile engineering. Today we'll discuss about the gears. So these are the important elements for an automobile. Okay, so we'll start with the gear transmission. So what is the importance of these gears and how many types of gears are generally used in automobiles? Today we'll see that. Okay, so that gearing is a very vital form of transmission of mechanical power, because that is very, very important for automobile. And it's fitted in all the cars, buses, trucks and every transport media. So these are basically transmitting the torque from one location to other. So these are in fact universally adopted for many other applications like machine elements, mechanisms and many more. Okay, so the types of gears that are generally used in automobiles are basically these: spur gears, helical gears, herringbone gears, bevel gears, rack and pinion, and worm wheel. So today we'll see the specialty of these gears along with their area of application and specifically to the automobile. Okay, where these are used in automobiles. So basically the first classification is a spur gear. So as we can see from these figures, that is a spur gear. So these spur gears are basically a mode of transmission that are employed for changing the speed. Okay, for speed reduction, for torque multiplication, we can obtain various gear ratios by changing the or varying the number of teeth on the driver and driven gears respectively, right? So these are the shapes of the gears that are known as spur gears. Basically they are straight in nature. So we can see the passageway here, it's a straight spur gear. Okay, so these are basically used in washing machines, sliding mesh gear boxes and blenders, and many more applications are there based on their requirement. Okay, so the prime importance is to multiply the torque and as per the requirement of the customers or as per the requirement of the vehicle. So these are used to multiply the torque. Okay, so other classification is helical gears. Basically the helical gears are used for transmission at an angle, and as we can see from these images, the gears are cut at an angle. So the axis may be inclined and the gears are cut at an angle. So due to this, the operation of these gears are noiseless because they are in constantly touch with each other. So looking to the first classification, the spur gears are used basically in sliding mesh gearbox of an automobile. So we'll, in this chapter, in later part, we'll study about the sliding mesh gearbox and other type of gearboxes commonly used in automobiles. Okay, so this was the second classification in which the teeth are inclined. So these are not parallel to the axis of the shaft. Okay, these are in fact inclined, teeth are inclined. So we can see from here. So these helical gears are one type of cylindrical gears with slanted tooth trays, okay, as we can see from this image. So as compared to the spur gears, what is the difference? They have large contact area ratio and excel in that quietness and less vibration and able to transmit large forces. Okay, so these are noiseless in operation. So this pair of helical gears has same helix angle, but the helix and that hand is basically opposite to each other. Okay, this also we can see here. So based on their constructional details and this profile, they are basically used in constant mesh type of gearboxes in automobiles. So these constant mesh type of gearboxes are quite popular in cars and other transportation means. Okay, so what is the benefit as compared to the spur gear? Because these spur gears were used in sliding mesh gearbox, where these one gear is fixed, other is slided on its axis using an spline shaft, and this engages with the second part. So if one gear is rotating, other comes in contact with it and just meshes. Okay, so this may create a noise while in meshing. Okay, but in this case, these are used in constant mesh gearboxes. We'll study about this constant mesh gearbox in which the two gears are always in constant mesh with each other, so there is no need to engage the gear while first one is in motion. Okay, so it is not possible to engage a moving gear to a that stationary gear just to transmit the power. So in order to transmit the power, they should be in continuous touch with each other. Rather, we can say that they should be in mesh with each other, or we can say that they should be engaged with each other. Okay, so this profile along with its principle, that is in constant mesh with each other, makes it noiseless. So due to this effect, the smooth transmission of small gears with fewer teeth at large transmission ratio can be obtained. And see, we can obtain up to a transmission ratio of 15:1, a very high torque multiplication may be obtained. Okay, so these are widely used in automobiles, cars, buses, trucks, etc. Okay, next classification, we'll see a modification of that helical gear. So this is known as double helical gear. As we can see, the helix are cut on on double basis. Okay, so this double helical gear, that is known as herringbone gear, is used for transmitting power between two parallel shafts. Okay, and in fact, due to this nature, it's complicated in its design, but when meshed together will perform quieter in operation. Okay, and it was developed to overcome the disadvantages of high end thrust that is present in single helical gears. So these are advantageous and may be used. Only the limitation is that they are quite complex in their construction. Okay, so next comes the bevel gears. For power transmission at 90 degree, we can use bevel gears. So this is used in our differential assembly. So differential assembly in cars or trucks is the final gear reduction that is being obtained at the rear end. Okay, so in case of like trucks, we want to transmit the power from the engine to the rear wheels. So we use multiple means of transmission, like multiple components, like gearboxes, we use clutches, we use propeller shaft and some joints like slip joints, universal coupling, followed by a differential. So in that differential, that is a final reduction drive, final reduction gearbox known as differential, this sort of gears are used. Okay, in that case, the power comes from a bevel pinion like this. This is a bevel pinion and this is our crown wheel in case of differential assembly. So we can see here the shafts of these two gears are at 90 degree or perpendicular to each other. So we can plot here the axis of this particular gear and the axis of this particular gear. They are 90 degree to each other. So this is the unique specialty of bevel gears, that they are able to transmit the power at 90 degree even. Okay, so these gears are used where axis of the two shafts intersect and the tooth bearing faces of the gears themselves are conically shaped. We can see here the shapes are conical in nature. So this is known as bevel gear. Okay, that is a modification of simple straight spur gear. Okay, but these are forming a cone at the outer end. Okay, so these are some of the examples where these can be used, and in many other applications, mechanisms, machines, these gears are used to transmit the power at 90 degree. So these are the bevel gears. So now talking about the worm and worm wheel gears. So this worm and worm wheel gears, what is the specialty? Large single stage speed reduction in perpendicular direction is possible. In a single stage, we can reduce the speed to a larger extent. Okay, so this basically a gear arrangement in which a worm, which is known as which is a gear in the form of a screw. Okay, it's a worm wheel, as we can see from here, the worm that is constructed in the form of a screw. So this is known as this meshes with basically a worm gear. This worm gear is known as that is like a spur gear. Okay, so these are also able to transmit the power at 90 degree. In that, what is the difference between that first one version, bevel gear and worm gear, is that the worm is in the form of a screw. Okay, it transmits the power and it is able to perform for a large single stage speed reduction purpose. Okay, so as this example quotes that this can be used in motors or prime movers to transmit the power or to perform this particular operation, that is large single stage speed reduction. So in terms of automobile, it is used in steering gearboxes. We'll study about various steering gearboxes in automobiles in our steering system. Okay, so in that we'll see that these steering gearboxes may be recirculating ball type, may be worm and worm wheel type, may be worm and nut type, may be rack and pinion type. So these are certain examples of the steering gearboxes where we can use as per our convenience or as per the design requirements. So this is one of the versions which is used in automobiles in their steering system. Okay, so this worm and worm wheel finds its application in steering gearboxes. Okay, just to steer the vehicle, we need to have a gearbox in which the wheel is being turned by the driver. That turning motion will be converted to the that oscillating motion of the steering mechanism. So we'll study in detail about steering gearboxes in our steering system chapter. Okay, so this is another common example, rack and pinion gearbox. And as I have told earlier, that this sort of gearbox is used in automobiles for performing the steering operation. Okay, and this is most common and most economical type of gearbox, that is known as rack and pinion gearbox. Okay, as you might have studied in your kinematics of machines, that this rack is a gear with infinite radius. Okay, so this may be termed as a gear with infinite radius, and this is our pinion. So this pinion transmits the rotates about its axis, and this rack is translating. So this sort of gearboxes are used in the automobile steering gearboxes. Okay, this sort of gears, and these are also used in the wiper mechanism or any other mechanism as required by the automobile. Okay, so this basically rack and pinion is a type of linear actuator, as we can see that which comprises a circular gear. This is a circular gear which is known as pinion, that engaging in a linear gear. That linear gear is a rack, which is known as rack, which operate to translate rotational motion into linear motion. This will be rotating, and this rotating motion will be transmitted to linear motion of the rack. Okay, so this rack and pinion drive can use both straight and helical gears. So in that case, because they are in constant touch with each other, so we can use straight as well as helical gears. Okay, both are suitable to be used in rack and pinion gearboxes. Okay, these are the references, and after that we'll begin the types of gearboxes that are used in automobiles.